This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Coordinates, 37 degrees 24 minutes 49 seconds north 122 degrees 08 42 W, 37,413,579 degrees north 12,214,508 degrees west 37,413,579, minus 12,214,508 Hewlett-Packard Company last logo of Hewlett-Packard used from 2010 to 2015. Now used by HP Inc. HP headquarters in Palo Alto, California, U.S. former type public traded. Hewlett-Packard Enterprise founded January 9,185 United States dollars. Services to consumers, small and medium-sized businesses SMBs and large enterprises, including customers in the government, health and education sectors. The company was founded in a one-car garage in Palo Alto by William Bill Reddington Hewlett and David Dave Packard, and initially produced a line of electronic test equipment. HP was the world's leading PC manufacturer from 2007 to Q2 2013, after which Lenovo came to rank ahead of HP. It specialized in developing and manufacturing computing, data storage, and networking hardware, designing software and delivering services. Major product lines included personal computing devices, enterprise and industry standard servers, related storage devices, networking products, software, and a diverse range of printers and other imaging products. HP marketed its products to households, small to medium-sized businesses and enterprises directly as well as via online distribution, consumer electronics and office supply retailers, software partners and major technology vendors. HP also had services and consulting business around its products and partner products. Hewlett-Packard Company events included the spin-off of its electronic and bio-analytical measurement instruments part of its business as Agilent Technologies in 1999, its merger with Compaq in 2002, and the acquisition of EDS in 2008, which led to combined revenues of $1,184. 2010, HP announced the buyout of Palm, Inc. for $12.2 billion. Facilities, 3 products and organizational structure, 4 staff and culture, 41 notable people, 5 corporate social responsibility, 6 brands, 7 HP Discover customer event, 8 controversies, 81 restatement, 82 spying scandal, 83 hardware, 84 lawsuit against Oracle, 85 takeover of autonomy, 86 Israeli settlements, 87 bribery, 9 see also 10 references, 11 external links. History. Founding and early years. The garage in Palo Alto where Hewlett and Packard began their company. Hewlett-Packard logo used from 1941 to 1964. William Reddington Hewlett and David Packard graduated with degrees in electrical engineering from Stanford University in 1935. The company originated in a garage in nearby Palo Alto during a fellowship they had with a past professor, Frederick Terman, at Stanford during the Great Depression. Terman was considered a mentor to them in forming Hewlett-Packard in 1939. Packard and Hewlett established Hewlett-Packard HP in Packard's garage with an initial capital investment of $538. Hewlett and Packard tossed a coin to decide whether the company they founded would be called Hewlett-Packard or Packard-Hewlett. HP incorporated on August 18, 1947, and went public on November 6, 1957. Of the many projects they worked on, their very first financially successful product was a precision audio oscillator, the model HP P200A. Their innovation was the use of a small incandescent light bulb known as a pilot light as a temperature-dependent resistor in a critical portion of the circuit, the negative feedback loop, which stabilized the amplitude of the output sinusoidal waveform. This allowed them to sell the Model 200A for $5,440 when competitors were selling less stable oscillators for over $200. The Model 200 series of generators continued until at least 1972 as the 200AB, still tube-based but improved in design through the years. One of the company's earliest customers was Walt Disney Productions, which bought 8 Model 200B oscillators at $7,150 each for use in certifying the Fantasound surround sound systems installed in theaters for the movie Fantasia. They worked on counter-radar technology and artillery shell fuses during World War II, which allowed Packard but not Hewlett to be exempt from from the draft 1960s, the HP-200A, a precision audio oscillator, was the company's very first financially successful product. HP is recognized as the symbolic founder of Silicon Valley, although it did not actively investigate semiconductor devices until a few years after the Traitorous Eight had abandoned William Shockley to create Fairchild Semiconductor in 1957. Hewlett-Packard's HP Associates division, established around 1960, developed semiconductor devices primarily for internal use. Instruments and calculators were some of the products using these devices. HP partnered in the 1960s with Sony and the Yokogawa Electric companies in Japan to develop several high-quality products. The products were not a huge success, as there were high costs in building HP-looking products in Japan. HP and Yokogawa formed a joint venture, Yokogawa Hewlett-Packard, in 1963 to market HP products in Japan. HP bought Yokogawa Electric's share of Hewlett-Packard Japan in 1999. HP spun off a small company, Dynic, to specialize in digital equipment. The name was picked so that the HP logo HP could be turned upside down to be a reverse reflect image of the logo Dai of the new company. Eventually Dynic changed to Dimec, then was folded back into HP in 1959. HP experimented with using Digital Equipment Corporation DEC minicomputers with its instruments, but after deciding that it would be easier to build another small design team than deal with DEC, HP entered the computer market in 1966 with the HP 2100, HP 1000 series of minicomputers. These had a simple accumulator-based design, with registers arranged somewhat similarly to the Intel x86 architecture still used today. The series was produced for 20 years, in spite of several attempts to replace it, and was a forerunner of the HP 9800 and HP 250 series of desktop and business computers. 1970s Hewlett-Packard logo used from 1964 to 1979. The HP 3000 was an advanced stack-based design for a business computing server, later redesigned with RISC technology. The HP 2640 series of smart and intelligent terminals introduced forms-based interfaces to ASCII terminals, and also introduced screen-labeled function keys, now commonly used on gas pumps and bank ATMs. The HP 2640 series included one of the first bit-mapped graphics displays that, when combined with the HP 2100-21MXF series microcoded scientific instruction set, enabled the first commercial WYSIWYG presentation program, Bruno, that later became the program HP Draw on the HP 3000. Although scoffed at in the formative days of computing, HP would eventually surpass even IBM as the world's largest technology vendor. In terms of sales, introduced in 1968, the new Hewlett-Packard 9100A personal computer is ready, willing, and able to relieve you of waiting to get on the big computer. Although Programma 101 was the first commercial desktop computer, HP is identified by Wired magazine as the producer of the world's first device to be called a personal computer, the Hewlett-Packard 9100A. Introduced in 1968, Programma 101 was called Computer Personal in Italian, at Fiera di Milano. 1966 HP called it a desktop calculator, because, as Bill Hewlett said, if we had called it a computer, it would have been rejected by our customers' computer gurus because it didn't look like an IBM. We therefore decided to call it a calculator, and all such nonsense disappeared, an engineering triumph at the time. The logic circuit was produced without any integrated circuits, the assembly of the CPU having been entirely executed in discrete components with CRT display, magnetic card storage, and printer. The price was around $5,000. The machine's keyboard was a cross between that of a scientific calculator and an adding machine. There was no alphabetic keyboard. Steve Wozniak, co-founder of Apple, originally designed the Apple I computer while working at HP and offered it to them under their right of first refusal to his work, but they did not take it up as the company wanted to stay in scientific, business, and industrial markets. Wozniak said that HP turned him down 5 times. Wozniak said his loyalty to HP made him hesitant to start Apple with Steve Jobs. The company earned global respect for a variety of products they introduced. The world's first handheld scientific electronic calculator in 1969 1972 the HP 35, the first handheld programmable in 1974 the HP 65, the first alphanumeric, programmable, expandable in 1979 the HP 41C, and the first symbolic and graphing calculator, the HP 28C. Like their scientific and business calculators, their oscilloscopes, logic analyzers, and other measurement instruments have a reputation for sturdiness and usability. The latter products are now part of spin-off Agilent's product line. The company's design philosophy in this period was summarized as design for the guy at the next bench. The 98x5 series of technical desktop computers started in 1975 with the 9815, and the cheaper 80 series, again of technical computers, started in 1979 with the 85. These machines used a version of the basic programming language which was available immediately after they were switched on, and used a proprietary magnetic tape for storage. HP computers were similar in capabilities to the much later IBM personal computer, although the limitations of available technology forced prices to be high. 1980s Hewlett-Packard logo used from 1979 to 2010. In 1984, HP introduced both inkjet and laser printers for the desktop along with its scanner product line. These have later been developed into successful multifunction products, the most significant being single-unit printer, scanner, copier, fax machines. The print mechanisms in HP's tremendously popular LaserJet line of laser printers depend almost entirely on Canon Inc.'s components print engines, which in turn use technology developed by Xerox. HP develops the hardware, firmware, and software that convert data into dots for the mechanism to print. On March 3, 1986, HP registered the HP.com domain name, making it the 9th Internet.com domain ever to be registered. In 1987, the Palo Alto garage where Hewlett and Packard started their business was designated as a California State Historical Landmark. 1990s In the 1990s, HP expanded their computer product line, which initially had been targeted at university, research, and business users, to reach consumers. HP also grew through acquisitions. It bought Apollo Computer in 1989 and Convex Computer in 1995. Later in the decade, HP opened HP Shopping.com as an independent subsidiary to sell online, direct to consumers. In 2005, the store was renamed HP Home. The story was initially reported by the Boston Globe, and it triggered an inquiry by the SEC. HP responded that products worth US$120 million were sold in fiscal year 2008 for distribution by way of Redington Gulf, a company based in the Netherlands, and that as these sales took place through a foreign subsidiary, HP had not violated sanctions. HP named Redington Gulf Wholesaler of the Year in 2003, which in turn published a press release stating that he seeds of the Redington Hewlett Packard relationship were sowed 6 years ago for one market, Iran. At that time, Redington Gulf had only 3 employees whose sole purpose was to sell HP products to the Iran market, according to former officials who worked on sanctions. HP was using a loophole by routing their sales through a foreign subsidiary. HP ended its relationship with Redington Gulf after the SEC inquiry. 2000-2005 Hewlett-Packard DeskJet 3845 printer. On September 3, 2001, HP announced that an agreement had been reached with Compaq to merge the two companies in May 2002. After passing a shareholder vote, HP officially merged with Compaq. Prior to this, plans had been in place to consolidate the company's product teams and product lines. Compaq had already taken over Digital Equipment Corporation in 1998. HP therefore still offers support for the former Digital Equipment products PDP-11, VAX and AlphaServer. The merger occurred after a proxy fight with Bill Hewlett's son Walter, who objected to the merger. Compaq itself had bought Tandem Computers in 1997, which had been started by ex-HP employees, and Digital Equipment Corporation in 1998. Following this strategy, HP became a major player in desktops, laptops, and servers for many different markets. After the merger with Compaq, the new ticker symbol became HPQ, a combination of the two previous symbols, HWP and CPQ, to show the significance of the alliance and also key letters from the two companies, Hewlett-Packard and Compaq, the latter company being famous for its Q logo on all of its products. In 2004, HP released the DV1000 series, including the HP Pavilion DV1658 and 1040. 2 years later, in May 2006, HP began its campaign, "The Computer is Personal Again." The campaign was designed to bring back the fact that the PC is a personal product. The campaign utilized viral marketing lighting, sophisticated visuals and its own website www.hp.com. Personal. Some of the ads featured Pharrell, Petra Nemkova, Mark Burnett, Mark Cuban, Alicia Keys, Jay-Z, Gwen Stefani, and Shaun White. 2006-2009. A sign marking the entrance to the HP corporate headquarters in Palo Alto, California. 2006 iPac 112 Pocket PC from 2008. On May 13, 2008, HP and Electronic Data Systems EDS announced that they had signed a definitive agreement under which HP would purchase EDS on June 30. HP announced that the waiting period under the Hart-Scott-Rodino Antitrust Improvements Act of 1976 had expired. The transaction still requires EDS stockholder approval and regulatory clearance from the European Commission and other non-US jurisdictions and is subject to the satisfaction or waiver of the other closing conditions specified in the merger agreement. The agreement was finalized on August 26, 2008 at $13 billion, and it was publicly announced that EDS would be rebranded EDS a HP company. The first targeted layoff of 24,600 former EDS workers was announced on September 15, 2008. The company's 2008 annual report gave the number as 24,700, to be completed by end of 2009. This round was factored into purchase price as a $15 billion liability against goodwill as of September 23, 2009. EDS is known as HP Enterprise Services on November 11, 2009. 3Com and Hewlett-Packard announced that Hewlett-Packard would be acquiring 3Com for $27. 2010-2012. A Hewlett-Packard Mini 1000 netbook computer, a type of notebook computer. On April 28, 2010, Palm, Inc. and Hewlett-Packard announced that HP would buy Palm for $12. Some observers have argued that Hurd was innocent, but the board asked for his resignation to avoid negative PR. Public analysis was divided between those who saw it as a commendable tough action by HP in handling expenses irregularities, and those who saw it as an ill-advised, hasty and expensive reaction, in ousting a remarkably capable leader who had turned the business around. Shares of HP dropped by 84% in after-hours trading, hitting a 52-week low with $9 billion in market capitalization shaved off. Larry Ellison publicly attacked HP's board for his ousting on September 30, 2010. Leo Apotheker was named as HP's new CEO, and President Apotheker's appointment sparked a strong reaction from Oracle chief executive Larry Ellison, who complained that Apotheker had been in charge of SAP when one of its subsidiaries was systematically stealing software from Oracle. SAP accepted that its subsidiary, which has now closed, illegally accessed Oracle intellectual property following Hurd's departure. HP was seen by the market as problematic, with margins falling and having failed to redirect and establish itself in major new markets such as cloud and mobile services. Citation needed. Apotheker's strategy was broadly to aim at disposing of hardware and moving into the more profitable software services sector. On August 18, 2011, HP announced that it would strategically exit the smartphone and tablet computer business, focusing on higher margin strategic priorities of cloud solutions and software with an emphasis on enterprise, commercial and government markets. They also contemplated selling off their personal computer division or spinning it off into a separate company, quitting the PC business, while continuing to sell servers and other equipment to business customers, was a strategy already undertaken by IBM in 2005. HP's stock continued to drop, by about a further 40%, including 25% on one day, August 19, 2011, after the company abruptly announced a number of decisions to discontinue its Webis device business, mobile phones and tablet computers. The intent to sell its personal computer division. At the time, HP was the largest personal computer manufacturer in the world, and to acquire British big data software firm Autonomy for a 79% premium, seen externally as an absurdly high price for a business with known concerns over its accounts. Media analysts described HP's actions as a botched strategy shift and a chaotic attempt to rapidly reposition HP and enhance earnings that ultimately cost Apotheker his job. The Autonomy acquisition had been objected to even by HP's own CFO. 3-6. On September 22, 2011, the HP board of directors fired Apotheker as chief executive, effective immediately, and replaced him with fellow board member and former eBay chief Meg Whitman, with Raymond J. Lane as executive chairman. Though Apotheker served barely 10 months, he received over $13 million in compensation. HP lost more than $30 billion in market capitalization during his tenure. Weeks later, HP announced that a review had concluded. Their PC division was too integrated and critical to business operations, and the company reaffirmed their commitment to the Personal Systems Group a year later in November 2012 wrote down almost $9 billion related to the Autonomy acquisition see below, takeover of Autonomy, which became the subject of intense litigation as HP accused Autonomy's previous management of fraudulently exaggerating Autonomy's financial position and called in law enforcement and regulators in both countries, and Autonomy's previous management accused HP of textbook obfuscation and finger-pointing to protect HP's executives from criticism and conceal HP culpability, their prior knowledge of Autonomy's financial position, and gross mismanagement of Autonomy after acquisition. 6 On March 21, 2012, HP said its printing and PC divisions would become one unit headed by Todd Bradley from the PC division. Printing chief Vyomesh Joshi is leaving the company on May 23, 2012. HP announced plans to lay off approximately 27,000 employees. After posting a profit decline of 31% in the second quarter of 2012, the profit decline is on account of the growing popularity of smartphones, tablets, and other mobile devices, that has slowed the sale of personal computers. On May 30, 2012, HP unveiled its first net zero energy data center. HP data center plans to use solar energy and other renewable sources instead of traditional power grids. On July 10, 2012, HP's server monitoring software was discovered to have a previously unknown security vulnerability. A security warning was given to customers about two vulnerabilities, and a patch released 1 month later. HP's official site of training center was hacked and defaced by a Pakistani hacker known to as Hitcher to demonstrate a web vulnerability on September 10, 2012. HP revised their restructuring figures. They are now cutting 29,000 jobs. HP had already cut 3,800 jobs, around 7% of the revised 29,000 figure. As of July 2012, 2013 present on December 31, 2013, HP revised the amount of jobs cut from 29,000 to 34,000 up to October 2014. The current amount of jobs cut until the end of 2013 was 24,600. At the end of 2013, the company had 317,500 employees. On May 22, 2014, HP announced it would cut a further 11,000 to 16,000 jobs, in addition to the 34,000 announced in 2013. We are gradually shaping HP into a more nimble, lower-cost, more customer- and partner-centric company that can successfully compete across a rapidly changing IT landscape, CEO Meg Whitman said at the time in June 2014. During the HP Discover customer event in Las Vegas, Meg Whitman and Martin Fink announced a project for a radically new computer architecture called the Machine, based on memristors and silicon photonics. The Machine is supposed to come in commercialization before the end of the decade, meanwhile representing 75% of the research activity in HP Labs. On October 6, 2014, Hewlett-Packard announced it was planning to split into two separate companies, separating its personal computer and printer businesses from its technology services. The split, which was first reported by the Wall Street Journal and confirmed by other media, would result in two publicly traded companies, Hewlett-Packard Enterprise and HP Inc. Meg Whitman would serve as chairman of HP Inc. and CEO of Hewlett-Packard Enterprise, Patricia Russo would be chairman of the enterprise business, and Dion Weisler would be CEO of HP, Inc. On October 29, 2014, Hewlett-Packard announced their new Sprout personal computer. In May 2015, the company announced it would be selling its controlling 51% stake in its Chinese data networking business to Tsinghua Unigroup for a fee of at least $24 billion on November 1, 2015. As previously announced, Hewlett-Packard legally ceased to exist and split into two companies, HP Inc. and Hewlett-Packard Enterprise. HP Inc. is the legal successor of the old Hewlett-Packard. The split was structured so that Hewlett-Packard changed its name to HP Inc. and spun off Hewlett-Packard Enterprise as a new publicly traded company. HP Inc. retains Hewlett-Packard's stock price history and its stock ticker symbol, HPQ, while Hewlett-Packard Enterprise trades under its own symbol, HPE Facilities. The research center of Hewlett-Packard in the Paris-Saclay cluster, France. HP's global operations are directed from its headquarters in Palo Alto, California, USA. Its U.S. operations are directed from its facility in unincorporated Harris County, Texas, near Houston. Its Latin America offices are in unincorporated Miami-Dade County, Florida, U.S., near Miami. From 2012 to 2015, it also had offices in Medellin, Colombia. Its Europe offices are in Meyrin, Switzerland, near Geneva, but it has also also a research center in the Paris-Saclay cluster. 20. Products and organizational structure. HP office in Japan. HP produces lines of printers, scanners, digital cameras, calculators, PDAs, servers, workstation computers, and computers for home and small business use. Many of the computers came from the 2002 merger with Compaq. HP as of 2001 promotes itself as supplying not just hardware and software, but also a full range of services to design, implement, and support IT infrastructure. HP's imaging and printing group IPG was described by the company in 2005 as the leading imaging and printing systems provider in the world for printer hardware, printing supplies and scanning devices, providing solutions across customer segments from individual consumers to small and medium businesses to large enterprises. HP Presario F700 F767CL iPac H4150 Pocket PC from 2003. Products and technology associated with IPG include inkjet and laserjet printers, consumables and related products, OfficeJet all-in-one multifunction printer, scanner, faxes, DesignJet and CTEX large format printers. Indigo Digital Press. HP WebJetAdmin Printer Management Software. HP Output Management Suite of Software. LightScribe Optical Recording Technology. HP PhotoSmart Digital Cameras and Photo Printers. HP Spam Snapfish by HP, a photo sharing and photo products service. On December 23, 2008, HP released iPrint Photo for iPhone, a free downloadable software application that allows the printing of 4 inches by 6 inches photos. HP's Personal Systems Group PSG claims to be one of the leading vendors of personal computers PCs in the world based on unit volume shipped and annual revenue. PSG deals with business PCs and accessories, consumer PCs and accessories, e.g., HP Pavilion, Compaq Presario, Voodoo PC handheld computing, e.g., iPac Pocket PC, digital connected entertainment, e.g., HP MediaSmart TVs, HP MediaSmart servers, HP MediaVaults, DVD-RW drives. HP resold the Apple iPod until November 2005. HP Enterprise Business EB incorporates HP Technology Services, Enterprise Services, an amalgamation of the former EDS, and what was known as HP Services. HP Enterprise Security Services oversees professional services such as network security, information security and information assurance, compliancy, HP Software Division, and Enterprise Servers, Storage and Networking Group ESSN. The Enterprise Servers, Storage and Networking Group ESSN oversees back-end products like storage and servers. HP Networking. Former Procurve is responsible for the NW family of products. They are a business unit of ESSN, and HP Camera with an SDIO interface, designed for use in conjunction with a Pocket PC. HP Software Division is the company's enterprise software unit. For years, HP has produced and marketed its brand of enterprise management software, HP OpenView. From September 2005, HP purchased several software companies as part of a publicized, deliberate strategy to augment its software offerings for large business customers. HP Software sells several categories of software, including business service management software, application lifecycle management software, mobile apps, big data and analytics service, and portfolio management software. Automation and orchestration software. Enterprise security software. ArcSight Fortify software. Atala TippingPoint. HP Software also provides software as a service, SaaS, cloud computing solutions, and software services, including consulting, education, professional services, and support. HP's Office of Strategy and Technology has 4 main functions, steering the company's $36. HP also offers managed services by which they provide complete IT support solutions for other companies and organizations. Some examples of these include offering professional support and desktop premier support for Microsoft in the EMEA marketplace. This is done from the Lakeslip campus near Dublin, Sofia, and Israel. Support is offered on the line of Microsoft operation systems, Exchange, SharePoint, and some Office applications. Outsourced services for companies like Bank of Ireland, some UK banks, the U.S. Defense Forces, the computerization project at Cambridge University Hospitals, NHS Foundation Trust, staff and culture. Further information, list of Hewlett-Packard executive leadership. The founders developed a management style that came to be known as the HP Way. In Hewlett's words, the HP way is a core ideology which includes a deep respect for the individual, a dedication to affordable quality and reliability, a commitment to community responsibility, and a view that the company exists to make technical contributions for the advancement and welfare of humanity. The following are the tenets of the HP way. We have trust and respect for individuals. We focus on a high level of achievement and contribution. We conduct our business with uncompromising integrity. We achieve our common objectives through teamwork. We encourage flexibility and innovation. Notable people: Michael Capellas, Compaq CEO, Chairman, HP President Steve Wozniak, Tom Perkins, Carly Fiorina, 2016 presidential candidate Matt Shaheen, Management Consultant Executive at HP Enterprise Services in Plano, Texas, Republican member of the Texas House of Representatives. List of HP Chairman and CEOs: John Schultz, HP Lawyer, Oracle lawsuit. Corporate social responsibility: in July 2007, the company announced that it had met its target, set in 2004, to recycle 1 billion pounds of electronics, toner and ink cartridges. It set a new goal of recycling a further 2 billion pounds of hardware by the end of 2010. In 2006, the company recovered 187 million pounds of electronics, 73% more than its closest competitor. In 2008, HP released its supply chain emissions data. In September 2009, Newsweek ranked HP number one on its 2009 Green Rankings of America's 500 Largest Corporations according to EnvironmentalLeader.com. Hewlett-Packard earned its number one position due to its greenhouse gas GHG emission reduction programs, and was the first major IT company to report GHG emissions associated with its supply chain. According to the ranking, in addition, HP has made an effort to remove toxic substances from its products, though Greenpeace has targeted the company for not doing better. HP took the top spot on Corporate Responsibility Magazine's 100 Best Corporate Citizens list for 2010. The list is cited by PR Week as one of America's most important business rankings. HP beat out other Russell 1000 index companies because of its leadership in seven categories, including environment, climate changes, and corporate philanthropy. In 2009, HP was ranked fifth. Fortune magazine named HP one of the world's most admired companies in 2010, placing it number two in the computer industry and number 32 overall in its list of the top 50. This year in the computer industry, HP was ranked number one in social responsibility, long-term investment, global competitiveness, and use of corporate assets. In May 2011, HP released a global responsibility report covering accomplishments during 2010. The report, the company's 10th, provides a comprehensive view of HP's global citizenship programs, performance, and goals, and describes how HP uses its technology, influence, and expertise to make a positive impact on the world. The company's 2009 report won Best Corporate Responsibility Report of the Year. The 2009 report's claims: HP decreased its total energy use by 9% compared with 2008. HP recovered a total of 118,000 tons of electronic products and supplies for recycling in 2009, including 61 million print cartridges. In an April 2010 San Francisco Chronicle article, HP was one of 12 companies commended for designing products to be safe from the start, following the principles of green chemistry. The commendations came from Environment California, an environmental advocacy group, who praised select companies in the Golden State and the Bay Area for their efforts to keep our planet clean and green. In May 2010, HP was named one of the world's most ethical companies by Ethisphere Institute. This is the second year in a row HP has made the list. Ethisphere reviewed, researched, and analyzed thousands of nominations in more than 100 countries and 35 industries to create the 2010 list. HP was one of only 100 companies to earn the distinction of top winner, and was the only computer hardware vendor to be recognized. Ethisphere honors firms that promote ethical business standards and practices by going beyond legal minimums, introducing innovative ideas that benefit the public. HP is listed in Greenpeace's Guide to Greener Electronics that ranks electronics manufacturers according to their policies on sustainability, energy and climate, and green products. In November 2011, HP secured the first place out of 15 in this ranking, climbing up three places with an increased score of 59, up from 55. It scored most points on the new sustainable operations criteria, having the best program for measuring and reducing emissions of greenhouse gases from its suppliers, and scoring maximum points for its thorough paper procurement policy. In the November 2012 report, HP was is ranked second, with a score of 57. HP does especially well for its disclosure of externally verified greenhouse gas emissions and its setting of targets for reducing them. However, Greenpeace reports that HP risks a penalty point in future editions due to the fact that it is a member of trade associations that have commented against energy efficiency standards. HP has earned recognition of its work in the area of data privacy and security. In 2010, the company ranked number 4 in the Poman Institute's annual study of the most trusted companies for privacy since 2006. HP has worked directly with the U.S. Congress, the Federal Trade Commission FTC, and the Department of Commerce to establish a new strategy for federal legislation. HP played a key role in work toward the December 2010 FTC report, Protecting Consumer Privacy in an Era of Rapid Change, after winning 9 straight annual Most Respected Company in China awards from the Economic Observer and Peking University. HP China has added the 10-year contribution award to its list of accolades. The award aims to identify companies doing business in China with outstanding and sustained performance in business operations, development, and corporate social responsibility. In its 2012 rankings of consumer electronics companies on progress relating to conflict minerals, the Enough Project rated HP second out of 24 companies, calling it a pioneer of progress. Brand A Hewlett-Packard sponsored Porsche 997 GT3 Cup. The company sponsored the HP Pavilion at San Jose, now SAP Center at San Jose, home to the NHL's San Jose Sharks. According to a Businessweek study, HP was the world's 11th most valuable brand as of 2009. HP has many sponsorships. One well-known sponsorship is Mission Space in Epcot at the Walt Disney World Resort from 1995 to 1999, and again from 2013. HP has been the shirt sponsor of Premier League club Tottenham Hotspur FC from 1997 to 1999. They were sponsors of Australian Football League club North Melbourne Football Club. They also sponsored the BMW Williams Formula One team until 2005, a sponsorship formerly held by Compaq, and as of 2010 sponsor Renault F1. Hewlett-Packard also had the naming rights arrangement for the HP Pavilion at San Jose, home of the San Jose Sharks NHL hockey team until 2013, in which the arena's naming rights were acquired by SAP AG, renaming the arena to the SAP Center at San Jose. The company also maintains a number of corporate sponsorships in the business sector, including sponsorships of trade organizations including FESPA Print Trade Exhibitions, and O'Reilly Media's Velocity Web Development Conference. After the acquisition of Compaq in 2002, HP has maintained the Compaq Presario brand on low-end home desktops and laptops, the HP Compaq brand on business desktops and laptops, and the HP Proliant brand on Intel architecture servers. The HP Pavilion brand is used on home entertainment laptops and all home desktops. Tandem's non-stop servers are now branded as HP Integrity Non-Stop. HP Discover customer event in 2011, HP Enterprise Business, along with participating independent user groups, combined its annual HP Software Universe, HP Technology Forum, and HP Technology at Work into a single event, HP Discover. There are 2 HP Discover events annually, one for the Americas and one for Europe, Middle East, and Africa. EMEA HP Discover 2011 Americas took place June 6-10, in Las Vegas at the Venetian Palazzo. The company demonstrated the Webis touchpad, introduced July 1, 2011. The HP Discover 2011 event in EMEA took place in Vienna, Austria, on November 29 through December 1, 2011. Controversies. Restatement. In March 2003, HP restated its first quarter cash flow from operations, reducing it 18% because of an accounting error. Actual cash flow from operations was $647 million, not $791 million as reported earlier. HP shifted $144 million to net cash used in investing activities. Spying scandal. Main article: Hewlett-Packard spying scandal. On September 5, 2006, Sean Cabalfin and David O'Neill of Newsweek wrote that HP's general counsel, at the behest of chairwoman Patricia Dunn, contracted a team of independent security experts to investigate board members and several journalists in order to identify the source of an information leak. In turn, those security experts recruited private investigators who used a spying technique known as pretexting. The pretexting involved investigators impersonating HP board members and 9 journalists, including reporters for CNET, The New York Times, Times and The Wall Street Journal in order to obtain their phone records. The information leaked related to HP's long-term strategy and was published as part of a CNET article in January 2006. Most HP employees accused of criminal acts have since been acquitted. Hardware. In November 2007, Hewlett-Packard released a BIOS update covering a wide range of laptops with the intent to speed up the computer fan as well as have it run constantly. Whether the computer was on or off, the reason was to prevent the overheating of defective NVIDIA graphics processing units GPUs that had been shipped to many of the original equipment manufacturers, including Hewlett-Packard, Dell, and Apple. The defect concerned the new packaging material used by NVIDIA from 2007 onwards in joining the graphics chip onto the motherboard, which did not perform well under thermal cycling and was prone to develop stress cracks, effectively severing the connection between the GPU and the motherboard, leading to a blank screen. In July 2008, HP issued an extension to the initial one-year warranty to replace the motherboards of selected models. However, this option was not extended to all models with the defective NVIDIA chipsets, despite research showing that these computers were also affected by the fault. Furthermore, the replacement of the motherboard was a temporary fix, since the fault was inherent in all units of the affected models from the point of manufacture, including the replacement motherboards offered by HP as a free repair. Since this point, several websites have been documenting the issue, most notably www.hplescom, a forum dedicated to what they refer to as Hewlett-Packard's multi-million-dollar cover-up of the issue, and www.nvidiadefect.com, which details the specifics of the fault and offers advice to the owners of affected computers. There have been several small claims lawsuits filed in several states, as well as suits filed in other countries. Hewlett-Packard also faced a class action lawsuit in 2009 over its i7 processor computers. The complainants stated that their systems locked up within 30 minutes of powering on, consistently even after being replaced with newer i7 systems. The lockups continued. Lawsuit against Oracle. On June 15, 2011, HP filed a lawsuit in California Superior Court in Santa Clara, claiming that Oracle Corporation had breached an agreement to support the Itanium microprocessor used in HP's high-end enterprise servers. On June 15, 2011, HP sent a formal legal demand letter to Oracle in an attempt to force the world's number three software maker to reverse its decision to discontinue software development on Intel Itanium microprocessor and build its own servers. HP won the lawsuit in 2012, requiring Oracle to continue to produce software compatible with the Itanium processor. HP was awarded $3 billion in damages against Oracle. On June 30, 2016, HP argued Oracle's canceling support damaged HP Itanium server brand. Oracle has announced it will appeal both the decision and damages. Takeover of Autonomy. See also, Autonomy Corporation section. Year earlier of the UK-based Autonomy Corporation PLC. HP accused Autonomy of deliberately inflating the value of the company prior to its takeover. The former management team of Autonomy flatly rejected the charge. Autonomy specialised in analysis of large-scale unstructured big data, and by 2010 was the UK's largest and most successful software business. It maintained an aggressively entrepreneurial marketing approach, and controls described as a rod of iron, which was said to include zero tolerance and firing the weakest 5% of its sales force each quarter, while cassetting the best sales staff like rock stars. At the time, HP had fired its previous CEO for expenses irregularities a year before, and appointed Leo Apotheker as CEO and president. HP was seen as problematic by the market, with margins falling and having failed to redirect and establish itself in major new markets such as cloud and mobile services. Apotheker's strategy was to aim at disposing of hardware and moving into the more profitable software services sector. As part of this strategy, Autonomy was acquired by HP in October 2011. HP paid $103 billion for 873% of the shares, valuing Autonomy at around $117 billion, £74 billion overall, a premium of around 79% over market price. The deal was widely criticized as absurdly high, a botched strategy shift, and a chaotic attempt to rapidly reposition HP and enhance earnings, and had been objected to even by HP's own CFO. 3-6 within a year, Apotheker himself had been fired, major culture clashes became apparent and HP had written off $88 billion of autonomy's value. HP claimed this resulted from accounting improprieties, misrepresentations and disclosure failures by the previous management, who in turn accuse HP of a textbook example of defensive stalling, seeks to conceal evidence of its own prior knowledge and gross mismanagement and undermining of the company, noting public awareness since 2009 of its financial reporting issues, 3 and that even HP's CFO disagreed with the price paid, 3-6 external observers generally state that only a small part of the write-off appears to be due to accounting misstatements, and that HP had overpaid for businesses previously the Serious Fraud Office. United Kingdom, and the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission joined the FBI in investigating the potential anomalies. HP incurred much damage with its stock falling to decades low. 3 lawsuits were brought by shareholders against HP, for the fall in value of HP shares in August 2014. A United States District Court judge threw out a proposed settlement, which Autonomy's previous management had argued would be collusive and intended to divert scrutiny of HP's own responsibility and knowledge, by essentially engaging the plaintiff's attorneys from the existing cases and redirecting them against the previous Autonomy vendors and management, for a fee of up to $48 million, with plaintiffs agreeing to end any claims against HP's management and similarly redirect those claims against